And that was one of my dad's favorite people in the world. And I'm going to tell you, he worshipped Elvis, and he was worshipping the wrong king. But anyway, I just want to tell you a little bit about my dad. Today, 1 year ago today, my dad passed away, and he requested me to take his ashes and spread them at Tribble's Mill Park. And that's what we were going to do if the rain permits. But I just actually want to get up here this morning and read. I hadn't got a lot to say, but I invited a lot of family, but I want to read John 3:16. That's my scripture this morning. And if you got a Bible, open it. But anyway, I want to read out of Matthew. I want to read a prayer. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day, Lord, our daily bread. Forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. But anyway, I just, like I said, Elvis was my dad's favorite. He at one time, I think he thought he was Elvis. They've told me since I was a little boy that we was kin to Elvis. And I used to get in fights in school because I would tell kids that I was kin to Elvis Presley, and they would say, no, you're not. But I guess that's what made me so tough. But I'm going to tell you now, he's not the king I want to talk about this morning. He's the king of rock and roll. But I want to talk about the king of the world. Yes. I want to talk about the king, God, yes, that gave his only begotten son, that whoever so believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. I don't even need to read the Bible. I can just quote that. But it's not just that. To be saved, we have to believe that with our whole heart. Yes. We have to know that he rose that third day. And he did all this for us. That's how much God loved the world to give. I mean, just imagine giving your only begotten son. But I just want to thank everybody for coming. Pastor Pruitt, it means a lot. Pastor Pruitt led me to the Lord in 1996. I mean, that's been a long time ago. I slip, I fail. But you know what? God has picked me up. And I'm going to tell you something. It's not about what's happened. It's what's fixing to happen. All right. And I'm going to tell you something, brother. And I know that. And I claim that. And one reason I want to be up here this morning, I want this documented, that my kids and my grandkids know that their papi or their daddy believed in God above, and that Jesus died for our sins. If nothing else comes of this, my grandkids and my kids will know that I believed in God. And, you know, and like I said, I told Pastor B I didn't have a lot to say, but anybody wanting to come to Tribble's Mill after the service, you're welcome to come, because this is my church family, and the family that's here that has showed up is my blood family. But, I just want to thank everybody for coming, and anytime you can, come visit. And Pastor B, I'm going to turn this over to you, because there you go. This is a good one. You want me to sing it?
My God, when I had also wondered, consider all the big worlds I have made, I see I hear the roll arms around the universe display. Sing it, Father.
When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation to take me home, what joy shall be.